Well, today, our guest in the studios of New Day is doing exactly that. She's living her life, she's enjoying herself, and she's doing exactly what she loves to do. She's the culinary architect, the celebrity chef. And by celebrity chef, I don't mean it just by the word, but she's actually a celebrity chef, as well as a hospitality consultant. She's cooked for Pharrell, she's cooked for Oprah, she's cooked for so many other, Drake, et cetera, et cetera. And she's here with us this morning. Chef Daddy is in the building. Hi, how are you doing?
I'm good, thanks for having me.
Thank you for joining us. It's wonderful to have you. This is your first time here in Ghana or West Africa, Africa.
No, Africa, period, yes.
Thank you.
First time on the continent, so I'm really, really happy that this was my first visit, first stop. I feel very welcomed here, So I'm loving it.
Nice one. How has your experience been so far?
My experience
here in Accra?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, it's been really good. Like, from the moment that I came, I think I got really spoiled because my friends hooked me up with like the whole VIP treatment. They picked me up from the tarmac. It was that deep. So I was like, I like this visit.
Nice one. You're the celebrity chef, so why not get the special treatment? But so far, since you are, you know, tailored towards the food side, the culinary side, let's talk a bit about the food experience so far. Have you had anything that's close to the taste of the Caribbean, seeing as you're from the Caribbean fundamentally?
I had something yesterday, even though I'm really having this no meat December. Ooh. But I am. I love soup, and I have a little story about that later, but I just love soup. So there was something called goat light soup.
Light soup, yeah.
So I had that yesterday, and nice. I was really close to a soup that we actually have in like Haiti. So
what's it called?
We call it bouillon.
Bouillon.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like goat light soup?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was like, okay, I could do this.
And I'm sure you figured out how to make it already, looking at the fact that, some of you are just, you come up with things like that. You taste it and you're like, okay, so this goes before that and this goes in here. You can tell every ingredient that's actually in there.
Oh, yeah, your spices are very familiar here. I think that's why I feel real good. Like, usually, as soon as I landed, I thought that, okay, well, maybe my stomach has to get adjusted and stuff, but no, it's just very familiar. There's something about Accra that's just very familiar to my body, so I'm loving it. Like, I don't even have to fake the funk or anything. Yeah. It's just give me some food.
That's right. So you find yourself in the right business space.
Yes.
Let's go back a bit to when you actually began all of this. I read somewhere that you wanted to be a lawyer.
Yes.
So you moved from law to food.
Yes.
How did your mom even take that?
Oh my gosh, it's really hard growing up in a Caribbean household, and especially when you have a full-blown scholarship for you to go to college, and you're just have everything paid off.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My mom is a hardworking single nurse, so when I told her that my passion just wasn't in law, and I want to be a chef. She's like, okay, well, if you want to do that, you're going to have to pay that out of pocket because I'm not doing it for you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, since you believe in yourself that
exactly.
much. I'm all for you for
pay
the
for
support,
yourself.
But go ahead and pay for it since you want to do it that bad because right now you have free education.
Okay,
what I mean?
That makes sense.
Yeah, so I was like, okay, I'll take that challenge. So I, had several jobs and I did both schools at the same time.
Wow.
Yeah, so I just had to show her that it was something that I really, really wanted and it has paid off.
So you finished the law as well and then You.
I actually finished half of it.
Okay.
And then I was like, you know what? I can't.
You're not doing anymore.
I just can't.
You found your passion.
Yeah.
But right now, we're actually showing something on the side as well. And I'm like, what exactly was going on there? Can you tell
us? Okay, so I have these amazing clients from Canada.
Okay.
And they're some YouTubers. And basically, they prank each other.
Yeah.
And it's such a fun-loving family. So I said, you know what? For my last meal with them, I'm going to go ahead and prank them too.
Oh.
And because they let me, because they have cameras around anyways. Mm-hmm. I had cameras around always recording me cook and stuff anyways to give them footage. So it was nothing weird for them to see the cameras there.
Yeah.
So when I actually had the fake finger ready, I ordered it on Amazon and everything. I made it,
Oh my gosh.
I made it black.
Like it was charred.
Yeah, exactly. So and then I chopped it off. And,
oh my gosh.
And then I used his son as an accomplice. And I just started screaming and I had like these $300 pants on and stuff. And I had like the fake blood on it.
Yeah.
So they thought it was real. They really thought it was real because it was like, why is there blood on her pants?
Wow. You go hard with your pranking.
Yes, yes.
And so they actually believed you.
They believed me. They're like, he, as soon as he said, let me call 911, I have to call 911 or something. I'm like, wait a minute. Let me wait for his wife. I'm like, okay, it's a prank.
Oh, good one. You have jokes? You've got jokes.
Yes, I
and
love
how
that.
How long did it take you to actually plan that?
It actually took me a week to plan that.
Oh, a whole week.
Just for me to get the right fake blood and the fake fingers and for me to make it look like my skin color and stuff like that. So, yeah, it took me a little bit.
Interesting. Very interesting. So, yeah, back to the story about the past again, before we actually do talk about your stay here and all that you have planned for your year of return activities. You said you started from rock bottom. That's in your words. The bottom of the bottom.
Absolutely.
You know, so after school, you had to find, you know, jobs for yourself. You weren't really taking even much from people. Would you say that that helped you actually build your business when you weren't making that much money? Would you say that helped you?
Yes, absolutely. So the days where I actually wasn't receiving actual funds from people, I was learning in different ways. The way that they move business-wise, the doors that they opened up for me because I was giving them free services.
Oh.
So it was just things that I was observing. I was being a sponge at that time. Mm. So when I did needed those contacts, all I just had to do was open my mouth because, you know, when you are a genuine person, people always gravitate towards that. Yeah. And it benefited me, like, on the long run because even though I didn't have the financial backing, everyone supported me. So I started my business with 63 cents in my account.
What?
I had nothing.
I thought you would even say dollars.
Nope. 63 cents.
Wow.
Yes.
And so how were you able to move around? Or they were funding at least those bits?
I was asking, Auntie, Mama, let me borrow your car. Someone stole my car before Christmas.
What?
Yes. It's just such tragic stories. I mean, my mom's house burned down where she built me like a culinary play kitchen in the back of the house just so I could just continue practicing on my craft.
Yeah.
Her entire house burned down because the contractors messed up the gas connections.
Just that?
Yes, yes. So she lost her entire dream house.
Wow.
So imagine the guilt that I had.
Indeed.
Yes, right? So so basically it's like, you know, when I really say rock bottom, like, people really just don't know. They see me playing with gold and I'm around all these celebrities and stuff now, but I've really had to, I've had some humble moments and I'm not afraid to, like, really get down in the dirt and make things happen.
Yeah, makes sense. So you'd advise that people should also consider the other opportunities and not just run for money when they're starting their businesses?
Absolutely, yes. Opportunity trumps the actual funds because when you're building a connection with someone, that lasts a lifetime.
Yeah.
Like, when I met Pharrell, Pharrell didn't know who I was at all. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That was something that he found me on Facebook.
Wow, just like that.
On Facebook because, you know, it was I was having a down moment. I was trying to get people drunk. I created a cake called Ciroc Cakes for New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
And he found it and he had his own liquor brand at the time.
Yeah.
So his assistant called me for a meeting.
Yeah.
I didn't know I was meeting with Pharrell.
Mm.
So when I met up with him, it was just like, you know, I just see something in you. I think you're a star and I just want to work with you.
Wow.
And we just went from there. And that's like, what, almost 10 years ago.
Oh, wow.
Like,
so
it's
a while.
Yeah, a long time ago.
And who else have you cooked for?
Okay,
aside,
so, yeah,
you know,
so
Pharrell,
so from Pharrell, it's P. Diddy. And P. Diddy, I've been rocking with him almost the same amount of time.
Oh, wow.
You know what I mean? And that's someone who believed in me again from not knowing me from Adam.
Mm.
He was just like, hey, is it humanly possible for you to get these cakes that you've been doing for Thanksgiving? And I got them done within 24 hours. And then again, he said, let me have 100 of them for DJ Khaled. I'm like, okay.
Did you say 100?
100 within 24 hours. Yes. And I had,
amazing.
I got it done. I couldn't say no. And mind you, I don't even have the funds to make this happen.
Yeah, that's true.
This is mom. Let me borrow something. Let me get this. But
exactly.
At the end of the day, they did give me a check, you know, further on. But it's just like, you just got to make
beautiful.
Stuff happen and believe in yourself. Once you believe in yourself, all doors open.
Amen to that. Amen to that. So what should we expect to see from you or from your camp during this Christmas season? You're here for a bit. So what should we expect to see from Chef Danny?
Okay, so I do have a brunch coming up Christmas Eve with Kwame Bishville.
Yes.
He's a local star here.
Yeah,
so partnering up with him was very just... organic. It just made sense. And we have an amazing America meets Ghana. Yeah, brunch going on. So I will have like 24 karat gold wings and stuff that I do there.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's going to be really, really nice. Mm. Like us coming together was just, it's heaven. I think we're going to actually really have the best brunch in Ghana.
Amen to that.
This season.
I'm looking forward to it. And yes. Would you have any cooking sessions perhaps to teach some people maybe?
I am definitely open to it. I have quite a few dates open in my schedule. Yeah. So I want to reach out to as much people as possible, work with as much people as possible, reach out to children.
Okay.
Because I'm really hands-on. I'm not one of those sadiddy people at all. Like, I love reaching out and actually being hands-on with people and just learning. Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, I've enjoyed chatting with you. Hopefully we can continue right after. I've been speaking to Chef Danny. How do we find you on social media though, in case we want to continue following you and all of that?
Yes, you can find me on Instagram. Instagram is pretty much where you can talk to me because I respond back. Again, I'm not sadiddy. So you can message me if you need help in the kitchen or anything. You know, definitely, like, just hit me up at Chef Danny, ChefDanie.
Chef Danny.
Yes.
Chef Danny, thank you so much for joining us here on TV3 New Day.
Thank you.
Ooh, I'm looking forward to 24th now, that exquisite dining experience with you and Bishville. Thank you so much for joining us once again.